For about 20 years, I worked in a corporate, it's like, our, it would be your number one telecom company in the state. So in Canada, our big telecom company there. And I was a corporate HR management there. And I did leadership development and training and counseling and stuff like that. And so then I was turning down a lot of stuff. I was having kids. I really wanted to be a mom. You know, I was a mom. I really wanted to be. I didn't want to pay somebody else to get to be with my kids. That was bothering me. So my husband and I talked, and we ended up, I ended up making my own business, really. And I picked up more coaching. And then companies, just through networking, asked me to come and consult with them. So under the umbrella of what I do this, you know, the stuff, regional schools, you know, this stuff. And then I also go to companies and do like motivational speaking and team building and leadership training and stuff like that. So yeah, a little bit of, I kind of kept that iron in the fire a little bit, but I don't do a ton of promoting and I'm not on social media and I do, everything's all word of mouth for me because it's enough. Like I've been my primary, I love doing this, but my family is my life. So. It seems like people say like, wow, your kids never see you. and my answer to that is, so I guess it's like shift work. So, I was home, I was away in St. Louis, came up here actually, I was supposed to serve for a couple days, and then I went home, but I was home for like 8 days before I, like, fully home. So, my kids got to grow up with me going to their field trips, and, I went to their volleyball games, and and I can adjust my schedule if there's something really big and important. Usually people are pretty good about it. It's not retreats, and so I can usually flip-flop things sometimes. I don't do a ton of that, but I guess that's way more than you asked. But my life story. And so, I dabble in, under that umbrella, I do this and some corporate stuff.
But that was an awesome answer.
And where do you do that?
Pardon?
Where do you do that?
Where?
Yeah.
Where do I live?
Yeah.
I'm from Canada, so I live sometimes that's enough for people. So I go to school, now like half of our program at school is American history, right? Well, we learn all about you, our news is you, like we are, you might as well be American. But I live just about an hour and a half north of Toronto. I live more out toward the cottage country, I live out like near Lake Simcoe, outside of Barrie, Midhurst is where I live. And so it's near, I'm going to call it a ski bump. It's skiing, but it's called a mountain in Ontario, but we don't have any. So it's as close as we have. So it's more out in activity land. It's got a lake and, stuff like that. So I'm not right in Toronto. I'm about an hour and a half north. So I just drive to the airport. I drive an hour and a half to Chorus. I drive everywhere, but I love where I live. I have a ravine, a waterfall, trees, and my family.
Oh.
It's great. Yes. So, yeah. Anyway, you would have 3 minutes before the end. So, you're still early. So, you can go home. You don't need to ask me anything more. Just to be nice.
I don't know if anybody has anything left in the tank for that.
Anybody left?
Well, we have November birthdays.
Oh, good.
Do you have a captive audience? So, because it would be difficult to take birthday food into the sanctuary on Tuesday, and because everybody's here, and because it's November, we have some birthday people. You, Miss Faith, and Carrie, I know you're right.
Happy birthday.
I just want to remind everyone on Tuesday we will be in the sanctuary. Please go vote first and then come to chorus. And also we have many things that need to go up the stairs. So if anybody has energy enough to help, so that we don't all have to take like 5 trips, all of this has to go up, all of the easel and all of this. So everybody could help do that. That would be great. Thank you.
And on Tuesday, since we're not meeting in here, it'd be helpful if some people can help grab the stuff from up here. This is a voting area, so if we can like maybe scurry in the back and grab like the microphone and piano and music stand and then bring it to the sanctuary, that would be great.